Hello, everyone. Today, I'll be talking about something disturbing I discovered while I was on LinkedIn. Yes, see, I hate LinkedIn. I'm gonna be real with you. I only have the account so I could, you know, collect intel on some news, save cringeworthy posts so I can roast later on my channel, and just keep up to date with my friends, see what they're up to. Anyway, unfortunately, I don't have anything fun on this video for you guys, but I do have something that's quite disturbing and it deserves a whole video on its own. For those of you who don't have a LinkedIn, please, like my younger audiences, don't have a LinkedIn. It will give you a headache. It's like, it's just like mom and dad memes all day, every day, but I don't know, I digress. Basically, there was a trend on LinkedIn a couple of months ago, and it was just normal people giving stupid advice and tips on how to spot a toxic person at work. Okay, these people have no credentials. They don't know what the hell they're talking about. Maybe they have life experience. I'll give them that. But yeah, like their tips are basically more harmful than they are helpful. They don't exactly tell you how to handle a toxic person. In fact, their advice to give you would be to cut a toxic person out of your life or to fire them. Yeah, you heard me right, to fire them. But do you know what qualifies as a toxic person to these people? All you have to do is disagree with them and you're considered toxic. It's just really dumb advice. Anyway, you guys get the general idea. So I noticed this profile that was popping up on my feed continuously for a couple of months, and I couldn't help but to follow her because she was dropping F-bombs left and right on LinkedIn, and it's like a train wreck ready to happen, you know, and you couldn't keep your eyes off of it. What you're looking at right now is the profile of LW Hawksby. Her personality is literally the Narcissist Hunter, author of Dangerous Normal People, a guide to hashtag Casanova Psychopaths and other toxic personalities. So to be more in on the joke, guys, pause this video for a second and read her about section. And yeah, keep everything in mind about everything she's saying. She's an advocate against cyberbullying, trolling, and stalking. Now, we're going to scroll a little bit further and look at her educational background. I mean, she's educated. Look, she has a degree for finance, accountancy, marketing, and international travel. Good on her. Yet, I couldn't help but to notice she doesn't have any credentials for narcissist hunting. She's not a psychologist. I don't know about you guys, but I'm more skeptical than most people and my red flags are going off at this point. So, knowing that she was published, I decided to go on Google and look up her book. Basically, you can buy her book anywhere. It's being sold at Barnes & Noble and on Amazon. On her Amazon page, she has 31 reviews and they all have 5 stars. So I want you guys to remember that small little detail. We're gonna go back to her LinkedIn profile and just kind of look at it for a second. Judging from her LinkedIn profile, she posts a lot of pictures of herself. Her selfie game is really strong here, guys. And there's a lot of self-promotion. There's really nothing wrong with that. She's trying to sell a book. According to her, she has a lot of bullies, trolls, and stalkers and whatnot. But I mean, from the looks of it, she's actually doing more of the trolling and the bullying. It's also very obvious that she can't handle constructive criticism. Okay, guys, I'm gonna make an educated guess here. Rather yet, I'll ask you a question. Do you think maybe she knows so much about toxic personalities and narcissists and psychopaths and whatnot? Maybe because, I guess, you kind of get the thought that maybe she is one. Because if you think about it, why is she so defensive and combative when it comes to criticism? And why are these people taking time out of their precious day to attack this woman relentlessly on LinkedIn when she's just trying to help people spot narcissists? There must be something going on here. And quite frankly, I think she's using this narcissist hunter thing as a facade. For those of you who haven't figured it out yet, LW Hawksby is a pen name. Ta-da! Mystery solved. No, I'm just kidding. It's actually this person named Lucy Haughey. You guys are like, who the hell is Lucy Haughey? Why do I care? Well, you're gonna find out today. So Lucy Haughey is this 38-year-old woman who is a mother of 3 sons, might I add. She won this reality TV show thing called Come Dine With Me. And in 2016, she was found guilty of sleeping with a 15-year-old boy. Yikes. Yikes. You guys want to know a real kick in the nuts? The kid that she banged was one of her kid's friends. Imagine being such a terrible mother that you cuck your own kids.
Lucy and her victim arranged a meeting on Facebook. And, you know, after doing the deed, Lucy sent a message to one of her friends bragging about basically taking this kid's virginity. And she said something which I'm going to quote real quick. She said, "He had a crush on me, but I also had a lot of respect for him. I'm glad it was me and not a skinny, skanky 15-year-old schemey. He wanted introducing. I'm an expert. It happened." Basically, you know what she's saying. She's saying, like, "I'm so glad he lost his virginity to someone more than twice his age and not someone his own age. Ha ha." That's super predatory. And yeah, like, her friend was so disgusted by this, she went and told the victim's mom. And the victim's mom reported it to the police, and that's how Lucy got caught. You guys are probably wondering if she got any jail time for this. No, she didn't get any jail time for this. She got 3 years of community service, and this wasn't the first time this lady got in trouble with the law.
Do you believe in red flags?
Because I do. Because a couple months before she bumped uglies with a 15-year-old, this story came out. So the headline reads, "Come Dine With Me winner facing jail after campaign of online abuse against boyfriend's ex." Lucy Haughey, who won the show back in January, sent Facebook messages to friends of Sharon Lowe, sent an obscene picture, and also rang Mrs. Lowe's mother. A winner of reality TV show Come Dine With Me is facing jail after admitting a campaign of online stalking towards her then-boyfriend's ex-partner. Lucy Haughey, 36, trolled Sharon Lowe for almost a year, bombarding her with threatening and abusive messages, leaving her terrified and humiliated. She sent Facebook messages to friends of Miss Lowe, directed at her victim, telling her that she knew personal information about her. Haughey left voicemail messages, sent an obscene picture message, and phoned Miss Lowe's mother to rant about her daughter. She pled guilty at Glasslow Sheriff Court to stalking Miss Lowe between June of 2015 and May 2016. Sheriff Linda Ruxton said, "This is one of the most serious types of online stalking that I have come across. It's sustained and it's wicked." That's her right there. That's LW Hawksby, guys. The person we're all taking narcissist advice from.
Do you guys want to take a wild guess on who she blames for these crimes that she's committed? I'll give you guys a hint. It's not her. She doesn't take personal responsibility.
Yeah, she blames everyone else.
She blames everyone else for her crimes. So for sending the harassing text messages to an ex-boyfriend's girlfriend and her mother, she told the court that her ex-boyfriend made her do it. He was so abusive, he made her do it, and she just did it. Guess what she got for that? Community service. And then later on that year, after getting caught with a minor, Lucy played two cards. The first one was painting her 15-year-old victim as like a stripper, you know? Like, he was so enthusiastic in partaking these activities with her. It was consensual. The second card that she tried to play was saying the real victim in this crime is her, because she was being abused by her husband, and her husband was so terrible to her that she doesn't know what right and wrong was anymore. So yeah, that's her bullshit. Aside from everything else, there's this one quote that just screams to me. So I'm just gonna read it to you guys. "I've been portrayed as this fat old predator rather than a sexy young lassie who had consensual sex with somebody shy of his 16th birthday. 16 is still illegal. 17 is still illegal. 18 can still be your son. Age is just a number and jail is just a room. Am I right?" And I think it's very bold of her to decide who the victim is. She doesn't get to decide who the victim is. That boy is clearly underage and really freaking stupid. But, you know, she's a 38-year-old woman with three kids. She should have known better, and she could have stopped it at any point in time. Anywho, with that being said, she's seriously messed up in the head, guys. After finding out all of this information, her LinkedIn activities and her Quora, everything just started to make sense. This LW Hawksby person, why they have this chip on their shoulder, all of that. Grandiose sense of self, the overcompensation, the need to drag all the other haters into the spotlight and publicly shame them instead of intellectually debating them. And you know what? Although I do agree that life is the best teacher for spotting out narcissists, whatever, I also think that it's dangerous that someone like Lucy is giving advice on how to spot a narcissist when she can possibly be one herself. Not only that, but she will label anyone else a narcissist if you disagree or criticize her just because she is published. This is an example of appeal to authority fallacy, except she doesn't have any authority to diagnose anyone as a narcissist, a psychopath, or a sociopath. One can argue that she's published, okay, sure, but nowadays anyone can publish a book. A normal, mentally stable person, after pleading guilty to bumping uglies with a minor and harassing an ex's girlfriend, would admit to their mistakes and right their wrongs. Lucy? No. She instead writes a book to refocus the narrative and throwing blame to act as the victim. The fact that she's attempting to conceal her wrongdoings and justify her disgusting behavior by blaming her actions on the other narcissist in her life is telling of a sociopathic and narcissistic behavior on her part. As a fellow friend on the internet, I urge you guys to really research what you find online and never fall into the trap of fully trusting a source. Honestly, I facepalmed myself when I saw that a lot of people I knew followed LW Hawksby or Lucy Haughey. Whether they were just getting intel or just really enjoy her quote-unquote content, I think giving someone like Lucy a platform is disastrous. It is tough to remove someone like her off of LinkedIn just because the platform itself wants people to put their best foot forward and they like to avoid conflict in general. Anywho, if you guys like more of this reconnaissance stuff, subscribe, like, do whatever you want. Thanks for listening. Bye.